Jackson, aka Lena the Art Diva.
Get some actual work done. Ms. Urban Carrie Bradshaw here, ready and willing to report on what's really going down in the news from my urban point of view, of course. Oh, but where are my manners? You're probably saying, who the hell is the Urban Carrie Bradshaw? So let me formally introduce myself and tell you a little bit about moi. On the surface, I am an artiste, not exactly a starving one, though, because I work hard for mine, baby.
I'm just a bill, the healthcare reform bill, and I got to give it to you, straight up and real. Some crazy people out there who just don't want to listen, don't want a black president, calling names to me to mention a crazy lady, Sarah Palin, telling folks to reload. We should reload her on a plane to the farthest zip code. People are dying, no denying that we need to send me through quick, fast, and right away. So today I'll pray that their will is to pass the healthcare reform bill.
I signed your bill. Now you're a law.
Oh, yeah!
Him. Together we are all in battle to navigate the tides of time. Join us for the ride of your life, the ride of all time.
Jackson. This mural that I'm working on, I've been struggling with the name all week. I knew about the project, Sade Adams along with Gogi and Johnson C. Smith University okayed commissioned this project to happen through a grant through Duke Energy, and I'm honored to be the artist chosen to do it.
It was my idea to bring in the mural with Miss Lena. She is so amazing. She thinks of ideas on the spot.
Here I am on the last day of the mural project at Johnson C. Smith University, and it's been an adventure for these 4 weeks that I've been painting, cutting, pasting, and putting together this project known as Tapestry. Tapestry is the name I finally decided on. I thought it was a great double metaphor because it not only expressed, or it showcases rather, the actual material that I've glued, cut and pasted to adorn the women on the wall, but also it represents what a tapestry is when you think of the definition of how all the threads connect to make one whole cohesive piece. That's the way I see these women. Otherwise, how else would you connect an Oprah Winfrey to a Frida Kahlo, to a Madam C.J. Walker? We're all women, and I believe we have more similarities than we have dissimilarities. So that's when I decided to name the tapestry, to speak on the ties, the threads that bind us all together. I have to say it's kind of bittersweet. I have come to really care about the young women that I'm working with here at Smith. The Greater Enrichment Program has been in existence for over 37 years. It was started by Bishop George E. Battle, and it's a way for the community to come together. We provide out-of-school care, after-school care, tutorial, and summer programming for at-risk students here in the neighborhoods that feed into Bruns Avenue, Ashley Park, Mary Oaks, and Thomasboro. We also have some community sites, and one of our community sites is Wallace Pruitt Rec Center. The students that attend there are in the sixth grade, and Ms. Lena Jackson has been working with them on understanding the concepts, the basic concepts of art.
Lena J here, and working on a mural for the Great Enrichment Program, also known as GEP, as everyone likes to call it, saw that something needed to be changed in the world to make it a better place. And in their own specific way, they've all done exactly that.
We chose GEP people because they help the earth and have confidence to do something nobody else did before.
And the people on the murals, they have done something that nobody else could, well, nobody else did, and they try to make a difference in the world.
That you have Dorothy Count Scoggins, one of four African-Americans to integrate the school system, endured the most abuse enduring the school system, integrating the school systems here in Charlotte, North Carolina. And you have Sarah Stevenson, also a pioneer in the civil rights movement. She is known for integrating the Parent Teacher Association. I have Romare Bearden, one of my personal heroes. Romare Bearden is, well, he's Charlotte's own. He's a world-renowned artist working in the collage medium. Was one of the most well-known artists during the Harlem Renaissance.
Today we are here with Charlotte artist Lena Jackson. So, I guess, what is some advice that you would give to someone who is trying to be an artist? What should they do?
First thing that comes to mind, gut instinct to say, draw all the time. Literally draw all the time. And I do mean by that carrying a sketch pad with you, because you never know where you'll get inspiration. I saw someone today with this rocking Superman t-shirt and these red stockings, and I was like, oh, I so want to draw her. So, you want to keep a sketch pad with you at all times, constantly draw, and draw everything. Draw rocks, draw leaves, draw people, draw stores. You need that, because an artist needs to have like a mental repertoire that they can go to when they're searching for something to draw on the spot. And as a caricature artist, somebody could ask me anything they want me to draw, and I don't have time to go Google it. So I need to have visuals, I need to have experience drawing different things. Go to museums, go to galleries, associate with other artists. Don't box yourself into your own little space and only have your work to look at. Don't get it twisted. Everyone is influenced by everyone. Everything is derivative of someone else's work. So yeah, maybe in the beginning your work will look maybe sort of like that artist or this artist, but that's important. But more than anything, I would definitely say surround yourself with art. Have other interests, but the best way to become an artist is to do art and to be around other people who do it as well.